welcome, everybody. This performance you're about to hear represents the end of a week-long journey for us here into the world of radio, drama, and radiophonics. We took The Dark Tower, the radio play that was performed last night in Orford Church, as a starting point for that journey. And that radio play was written by Louis MacNiece and scored by Benjamin Britten over 70 years ago. And so we looked at various excerpts from that radio drama, and then looked at various excerpts from more contemporary radio dramas, and focused on the way in which the sound and music for that art form has developed and changed over the intervening 70 years. And unsurprisingly, that led us on to discuss technological advances, the ability to record and to tape, edit, manipulate and process sounds and use those sounds as part of a composition. We looked at the art of field recording, abstracting sounds from the environment, and the art of organising those sounds, and that being a part of the compositional process. So with the invaluable help of Robin Brooks, who I can see here in the audience, who's responsible for the performance last night, he was the director of the play last night, we together selected some texts that came out of themes that are explored in The Dark Tower, I suppose. Specifically, the themes that interest us were the theme of illusion and the theme of the dragon, which is that dark force, whatever that might be. And so we set about creating a collection of pieces using all of the techniques that we've been discussing. So I think it's very important we understand everything you're about to hear was made here in the past few days. All of the noises you will hear has been recorded and created by these people in this room over the past few days. No samples were used that were previously, well, we made it all here. In addition to that, I'm not going to go on forever, but just to explain, because it's a slightly unusual performance, we wanted to explore the music from The Dark Tower, Benjamin Britten's music a little bit. And so taking a tiny offering, a melody, a rhythm, or a harmonic language, we used that as a starting point and created some purely instrumental pieces of music. So the entire programme is new music, which is a credit to the creativity of the musicians here. It really is. I mean, it's about 39 and a half minutes long, one focused piece of music without any break, and it's entirely new and it's entirely written by these people, so I hope you enjoy it.
Music like the opening of the coronation anthem, which gave the feeling of a vast march of infinite cavalcades filing off, and the tread of innumerable armies. The morning was come of a mighty day, a day of crisis and a final hope for human nature. Then suffering from some mysterious eclipse and laboring in some dread extremity. Somewhere, somehow, a battle, a strife, an agony was conducting, was evolving like a great drama or piece of music. Thank you. Then, like a chorus, the passion deepened. Then came sudden alarms, hurryings to and fro, darkness and light, tempest in human faces, and at last, with the sense of all was lost, female forms and the features that were worth all the world to me. But a moment allowed, clasped hands, and heartbreaking partings, and then everlasting farewells. And with a sigh, such as the caves of hell uttered the abhorred names of the dead, the sound was reverberated. Everlasting farewells. And again. And yet again. Reverberated. Everlasting farewells. Basic principle must be the absolute rule for the SS men. We must be honest, decent, loyal, and comradely to members of our own blood and to nobody else. What happens to a Russian, to a Czech, does not interest me in the slightest. What other nations can offer in the way of good blood of our type, we will take, if necessary, by kidnapping their children and raising them here with us. whether nations live in prosperity or starve to death, interests me only so far as we need them as slaves for our culture. Otherwise, it's of no interest to me. Whether 10,000 Russian females fall down from exhaustion while digging an anti-tank ditch interests me only insofar as the anti-tank ditch for Germany is finished. Most of you here know what it means when 100 corpses lie next to each other. When there are 500 or when there are 1,000. To have endured this and at the same time to have remained a decent person, with exceptions, due to human weaknesses, has made us tough. And is a glorious chapter that has not and will not be spoken.
power you know fleetingly in your world is here.
It's here. Battle. The struggle. and cried aloud, "I will sleep as I will sleep." Hallucination. And she understood.
Hallucination.
It's my bathroom mirror, though, so there was something wrong with my mirror. It's gone. It's really gone. Struggles and cried aloud, "I will sleep no more."